Good morning, dear students. Yesterday, only one or two questions were left. We were able to do textbook question answers, but I was just telling you some of the extra questions that you were supposed to do in your fair notebook. So we are going to continue with the same one. So take out your notebooks and write down these questions only. Okay, we will be discussing these answers. So I think I have given you two extra questions yesterday. Okay. So now write down question. Why did Prashant go to the write down question? Why did Prashant go to the Red Cross shelter. Red Cross shelter. Who was the first to meet Prashant? Who was the first to meet Prashant? There. Okay. So, bache, what was the reason that Prashant went to the Red Cross shelter? What was the reason behind? And who was the first to meet Prashant there? All of you find out this answer. Start finding. So find out who is going to tell me this answer first. So who is going to tell me this answer? I would be appreciating those children who actively participate in my class. So who is the first one? Hurry up. Tell me, what was the reason? He was searching his family. He was searching.
Ma'am, can I? Ma'am, may I?
Okay, you tell me.
Prashant went to Red Cross shelter to look for his family members as his home was completely destroyed by the cyclone. He knew that he might find someone there. His maternal grandmother was the first person to meet him there.
Very nice. Very, very good. Your answer was perfect. So you guys really want to appreciate you. Okay, so who would be the next one to tell me this correct answer? Paranshi, you are not participating in class nowadays. What is the reason behind that? You tell me the same answer. After Paranshi, Dipanshi also, you tell me this answer. Pranshi and Dipanshi, both are supposed to tell me same answer, one by one. Hurry up. This is the simplest answer. It is given very much crystal clear in your English books. If you have gone through this chapter very, very carefully, you can give me this answer. Only Simran and Renuka, two students are raising hands. What about others? This chapter is not clear to you? Tell me. This chapter is not clear to you? Yes, Pranshi? No response. So shall I mark you absent at that time? Dipanshi, you tell me the same answer. Dipanshi is not also participating nowadays. Sudiksha, you tell me.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yes, Dipanshi, you tell me. You are unmuted now. Tell me.
Prashant went to Red Cross shelter to look for his family members at his home was completely destroyed by the cyclone. He knew that he might find someone there. His maternal grandmother was the first person to meet him there.
Okay, good. Good. Arzu, you tell me same answer. Yes, Arzu.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, because he thought that his family was in the Red Cross shelter because in his village, all the houses were washed away due to cyclone and Red Cross shelter is place where people were saved from the cyclone.
Why have you started your answer from the word because? Is it right? Tell me. So who was the first one he met there? Who was the first one? His maternal grandmother. So he was in search of his family. He was so desperate. He was so anxious and worried for his family. He wanted to search his family member. So what did he do? He went in Red Cross, you can say Red Cross shelter to find out the family members. And there was his maternal grandmother. To whom did he find? At first. Okay, so bachche, now there is a long question that I'm going to tell you. You have to do this long question. This is the long question from this chapter, and this is the last one. You can say only one question is left, so you have to do this question by keeping this thing in your mind that it should be of near about 4 to 5 marks. So you have to tell each and everything in detail. Okay, so write down, why was Prashant describe the role of Prashant as the leader of his village, as the leader of his village. So you have to write down in bracket 5 marks, okay? Because this question, you think in this your mind, think in your mind that this question is carrying 5 marks. So how should be the arrangement of ideas? Because each and every role you have to write down in detail. By framing small paragraph, you can frame this answer, okay? So start writing content on this. One of the child will not be telling me whole answer. I will be going to make a network. See how I'm going to start this answer. One student will start the answer, second will continue, third will continue, fourth will. Okay, so in this way, you all should be attentively listening this answer. I can ask any of the child to continue their answer from the previous one. Okay?
Ma'am, may I?
So we should make a chain of this long answer. So first I'm going to start to Renuka. After Renuka, Simran. Clear? Clear? So Renuka, I can tell you to stop at any of the point, then Simran is going to start this. Okay? So it is just like a game also, and you will be enjoying this class also. And in this way, you will be attentive also. Any of the child can be asked to speak. So Renuka, you start. The role of Prashant as the leader of his village. First, give introduction, the age of Prashant. He was youngster. And what did he
Prashant
do?
Prashant was...
Yes.
Prashant was a teenager living in the village in coastal Odisha, in a small village, Kalikuta. he went to his friend's house when the storm came. By default.
Wait. Now Simran, you start from there. After Simran, Dipanshi should be ready.
Prashant was just a teenager living in the small village of Kalikuda in Orissa. Prashant was just a kid who had never, but then the cyclone came. Prashant was just a kid who had never experienced such a disaster. He went to meet his friend happily, but got stuck on the rooftop for 2 days with nothing to eat.
Wait. He stuck on the roof. After that, Dipanshi, you start. After Dipanshi, Laksh Jairath should be ready.
Prashant is a young boy, just 19 years old. He finds himself in a village by the superstorm in Orissa. He visits a storm shelter in his village and decides to help them out. He takes up a leadership role and starts organizing the people. For several months, he helps the people to overcome their difficulties.
In your answer, you are using present tense. No, bache, it is wrong. In every line, you have to use past tense because you are going to share experience of Prashant. What role did he play? So here you are supposed to use only past tense, not present tense. Okay? So after Dipanshi, Laksh Jairath, where are you? I'm not able to find out you. You raised your hand. Laksh Jairath. Okay, you tell me this answer. Now Laksh is not here. So I'm going to mark him absent. Clear? So after that, Dhiren, you continue this answer. And after Dhiren, Jasleel Khosla will continue. Dhiren.
In such a way, Prashant controlled the situation was quite advisory. I think that this Prashant is a too good leader. He teamed up the young youth of his shelter and asked them to make the things go away in such a way that that neutralize the situation. First of all, he organized a team to force a merchant to part his rice with the shelter. Moreover,
wait. To part some of the rice to the shelter. Then Jasleen, you tell me. After Jasleen, Nitya should be ready.
Yes, ma'am. Once they got rice from the merchant, they collected the broken branches of the tree. The Prashant also organized a team of youth volunteers who cleaned the shelter of urine, vomit, floating carcasses, and he also gathered the orphan children together and mobilized the woman to take care of them.
Okay, good. Nitya, you continue. After Nitya, Parmeet will be speaking.
Prashant showed leadership qualities and guided the youngsters of his village.
Nitya, you will not start this answer from the very beginning. You will start from where Jasleen has left the answer. She was speaking that he started making a cleaning campaign in which he removed filth, dirt, urine, dead bodies of animals and human beings. He cleaned all this thing. You start from there.
Prashant gathered his youth and cleaned the urine, vomit, and human waste. He also picked up carcasses and cleaned the village. He tried his best to clean the village. He also helped the widows and the orphans in the shelter. He made foster families with orphans who couldn't receive the love of their parents and widows who had suffered the loss of their child.
Okay. After that, to whom did I speak? Did I tell to speak? Who was that? Raise your hand. Raise your hand. Who was that after Nitya? Parmeet, yes. I forgot. Yes, Parmeet. Where is he? Parmeet, raise your hand. Parmeet, I'm not able to find out him. He has left the class. See, this is the way I have come to know that how many of you are actually participating in class and I'm not audible. One of the students is sending me, my voice is not coming. Am I audible to you? Arzu,
ma'am, 100% audible.
So Arzu, only you are having problem, beta, and in your network. So where has Parmeet gone? He has left the class. So he will be marked absent today. Now after that, who is going to conclude the answer? Tell me. Willingly, they can tell me who is going to conclude this answer. Okay, Ashmeet, you conclude this answer. Ashmeet Kaur. Shivraj, can you conclude this answer? Shivraj or Sahil? Shivraj or Sahil, any of you can conclude this answer? See, it means they are not present. Shivraj? Shivraj? See. Okay, Pranay, you tell me this answer. You are showing me thumbs up. Pranay, you tell me. You conclude this answer.
Prashant helped the people by making the merchants agree on distribution of food among the villagers. He arranged shelters for the people. He also made a union to help the people who gave them food and shelter. By this, we can conclude that Prashant is a very good leader.
Good. Renuka, I have told you yesterday to send me screenshot of attendance, but you didn't send. What happened? What was the reason?
Ma'am, actually, I was due to some reason, my health problems, and I was doing my work of school, so I wasn't able to send. I will send you yesterday and today.
Okay. So now, bachche, your this chapter is over. You can do this chapter in your fair notebook. Okay. Now, afterwards, I'm going to start next chapter. That is the last leaf. That is a very interesting chapter. Let's do. So last leaf, okay? Before understanding this chapter, I'm going to tell you about the main characters of this chapter. Then I will be giving you the brief introduction, what is given in this chapter. See, in last leaf, there are three main characters. First is Siu, next is Jonsi, and next we have Behrman. Whole of the story revolves around only three characters, Siu, Jonsi, and Behrman. Okay, basically what happened, this chapter is about two artist friends. Okay, and Siu and Jonsi, they both are living together. Okay, so what happens, they both are living together. Okay, and what happened, once upon a time, Jonsi was not feeling okay. He fell ill and he was not recovering at all. So when Siu came to know about this thing, that Jonsi was thinking only this thing, that he would die one day. What was the mentality of Jonsi? That she would die one day. So this was assumption, this was the thinking that was residing in the mind of Jonsi, that one day she is going to die, she would not recover at all. So when his friend, when her friend Siu came to know about this thing, so what decision she has taken, she wanted to save the life of her friend, okay? So what happened, because she, there was one of the creeper, outside their window, and Jonsi was looking at that creeper and she was thinking with the leaves of the creepers were falling down due to autumn season. It was a season of autumn, the leaves were falling down, and what mentality she has developed that when only when all the leaves would be falling down, her health would go down and down, and when only one leaf would be there, it means she would die at that time. So such kind of mentality she has developed. She has developed such kind of assumption in her mind. Okay. Proper convincing was done, but she was not able to be convinced by any of the person. Finally, one of the neighbor came, and who was that neighbor? It was Behrman. It was a great painter. Okay, who finally came there, and what did he do? He painted plastic leaves. Okay, and after that he painted plastic, he pasted on that wall. Okay, he stick to those creepers. Okay, and this action was done when Jonsi was falling asleep. It was raining outside. Behrman got completely drenched, completely wet. He got pneumonia and he fell ill, and he died in that, you can say, situation when he was trying to save the life of Jonsi because he was making artificial leaves there. So in this process, Behrman's life was in danger. He got pneumonia and finally he died. But Jonsi, she recovered, and she thought that there are so many trees. Sorry, there are so many leaves on that tree. It means she is not going to die. Her condition started improving because of her mentality, because of her assumptions and thinking. Okay, so in this way, this whole chapter is described so beautifully. So we are going to read about this chapter, which revolves around three characters only. This is Jonsi, this is Siu, and this is Behrman. Okay, so I'm going to start this chapter. So who's going to read first page? Okay, Renuka, you read first page.
Siu and Jonsi, two young artists, shared a small flat. The flat was on the third story of an old house. Jonsi fell very seriously ill in November. She had pneumonia.
Pneumonia. She would lie on it her is, bed. Wait, it is pneumonia. P is silent here.
Okay, ma'am. She had pneumonia. She would lie on her bed without moving, just gazing out of the window. Sue, her friend, became very worried. She sent for the doctor. Although she came every day, there was no change in Jonsi's condition. One day, the doctor took Sue aside and asked her if anything worrying Jonsi. No, replied Sue. But why do you ask? Doctor said, Jonsi, it seems, has made up her mind that she is not going to get well. If she doesn't want to live, medicines will not help her. Sue tried her best to make Jonsi take an interest in things around her. She talked about clothes, fashions, but Jonsi didn't respond. Jonsi continued to lie still on her bed. Sue brought her drawing board into Jonsi's room and started painting. To take Jonsi's mind off her illness, she whistled while working. Suddenly, Sue heard Jonsi whispered something. So she quickly rushed to the bed and heard Jonsi counting backward. She was looking out of the window, was saying 12. After some time, she whispered 11, and then 10, then 9, 8, 7. Sue anxiously looked out of the window. She saw an old heavy creeper climbing halfway up the brick wall opposite their window. In the strong wind outside, the creeper was shedding its leaves.
Now see, listen. So here what is given in this chapter, that there were two friends. What was their name? Their name was Siu and Jonsi. Okay, so they were basically living in a small flat. Okay, and they were living on the third story. Third story is the third floor. Here story means floor. Third floor of an old house. Okay, so they both were artists. They used to do paintings for living. Okay, so one day what happened, Jonsi fell ill, and what kind of disease she was having? She was having pneumonia. See, its pronunciation is pneumonia. P is silent here. So bache, keep this thing in your mind. Don't pronounce this word wrong. It is pneumonia. Clear? speak all of you, it is pneumonia. P is silent here. Okay. So when she fell ill, she was suffering with pneumonia. All the time she was on her bed and she was just gazing out. Gazing out means continuously looking. Okay. So gazing means to look continuously. So she was looking out of her window continuously. So by looking at such kind of conditions, you also became worried. Okay. So she called for doctor. Okay. The doctor was coming every day, but there was no change in the condition of Jhansi. So one day what happened, doctor, what did he do? He took Sue aside and he say that, is there something that is giving, that is making Jhansi so anxious and worried? So Sue said, no, why are you asking me this thing? What happened actually? Because doctor, you can say, interpreted this thing that Jhansi has developed this thing in her mind that she is not going to recover at all. That she would not be recovering. This is the way, this is the reason that medicines are given, proper treatment is given, but still she is not recovering at all. So this is the reason that she is not recovering, because she has made up her mind that she is not going to be, you can say, she is not going to repair. She is not going to recover at all, okay? Because she has made up her mind. So in this way, no medicine, no treatment would be able to help her, okay? So Sue, as a very good friend, she took Jhansi's care. She was, you can say, taking care of her thing. She was talking about fashion. She was talking about clothes. Okay, but Jhansi was not responding at all. She was only 24 hours, she was on her bed. And Sue also brought drawing board also in her room that she should be busy by painting something. Okay, so she started so that she could start painting and her attention would be diverted. Okay. So such kind of efforts were done by her friend. Okay, but when she was working, she was whistling. It means she was not able to breathe properly. Okay, so suddenly Sue heard that Jhansi was whispering something. She was trying to say something. So she really rushed to her bed and she listened what Jhansi was speaking at that time. So you would be surprised to listen this thing. She was looking out of window and she was counting in a reverse order, like 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, and she was looking out of the window. So Sue got really surprised, actually, what is going on? Why she was looking out of window and she was counting in a reverse order? Basically, there was a ivy creeper. Ivy creeper is a kind of creeper, okay? So it was, you can say, halfway up to on the brick wall and opposite of their window. From their home, from their room, they both were able to see that. Strong wind was outside, it was blowing on. It was autumn season, and because of autumn season, its leaves were getting down, its leaves were falling down. Okay. Now, okay, Dhiren, you read.
Yes, ma'am. What is it, dear? Sue asked. Six, whispered Jhansi. They are falling faster now. 3 days ago, there were almost 100 leaves. There are only 5 left now. It is autumn, said Sue, and the leaves will fall. When the last leaf falls, I will die, said Jhansi with finality. I have known this for the last 3 days. Oh, that's nonsense, replied Sue. What have old ivy leaves to do with your getting well? The doctor is confident that you will get better. Jhansi did not say anything. Sue went and brought her a bowl of soup. I don't want any soup, said Jhansi. I'm not hungry. Now there are only 4 leaves left. I want to see the last one fall before it gets dark, and then I will sleep forever. Sue sat on Jhansi's bed, kissed her, and said, you're not going to die. I can't draw the curtain, for I need the light. I want to finish the painting and get some money for us. Please, my dear friend, she begged Jhansi, promise not to look outside the window while I paint.
Okay.
All right.
Wait. Now, what is given on this page? Okay. So, when she was whispering something, she was counting in a reverse order. So you asked that, what are you counting? So, John C. revealed that secret that she was looking outside. There is a one ivory creeper, and within 3 days, 100 of the leaves are almost gone, almost fallen down, and only 5 leaves are left. So, Sue says it is the autumn season. That's why it is happening. It is nothing to do with your life. So, no. John C. has made this assumption that she was very much confident. She made this assumption that by falling the leaves, her condition was going down and down. But Sue said that the doctor is very much confident that one day you will be completely recovered. You just take this soup and take care of yourself. So John C. said, no, I'm not feeling hungry. I'm not going to take any kind of soup, etc. Because only when one leaf will left, okay, only then it will be the time when I will die. So Sue consoled her, she took care of her, she kissed her, and she said, no, you are not going to die at all. So she said that I'm going to draw the curtain so that you are not able to look outside. So John C. became so stubborn, so obstinate at that time. She said, no, you please don't draw the curtain because I need light, okay? And I want to finish this painting and I want to get some money for, okay? So in this way, they were not able to draw the curtain because painting work was going inside, okay? So she begged John C., okay? She said, okay, I'm allowing you, but you just promised that you would not look outside at all. Okay, so well, I'm going to do painting, but you would not be looking outside. So such promise was made between two friends. Now, bachche, we are running out of time. Okay, we will be continuing this chapter tomorrow. Up to this, you also read at home. If you find any kind of difficulty, any of the text, any of the line is not clear to you, you can ask me. Okay, bachche? And you do question answer of the chapter that we have discussed, Weathering the Storm in Ersama. You do those question answers in your fair notebook, okay? Because whatever the work we have discussed, you are supposed to do the same work on your fair notebooks. And according to the sent schedule, you will be sending me your fair notebooks to be checked. Okay, bachche? Take care of yourself and do your work side by side. Clear?